This is Father Christian Carlassare, Bishop Elect of Rumbek Diocese. Hello to everyone, and thanks to SCI Africa for giving me the opportunity to deliver this message. I address you still from a bed of the hospital, but with full of hope. First of all, I want to thank all Christians around the world that have been praying for me and are giving me so much courage and trust in the Lord. Then I acknowledge also the solidarity, a powerful stand of my elder brothers, the bishops of Sudan and South Sudan, as they see that this attack to one member is the attack to the whole church. I am grateful for the sincere commitment of the government, from the presidency to the authorities at the local level, to appeal the truth and take legal actions to correct the evil that has happened in Rumbek, so that it may never happen again. Mass media also has given large coverage of the incident. Let it not be to shame or to confuse, but to inform on the facts. I read titles such as "Rumbek shot the bishop," or internationally, "South Sudan shot a bishop." Such a shame. Many innocent South Sudanese wrote to me saying, "We are sorry for what South Sudan did to you." And I answered, "Please be at peace. It is not the people of South Sudan who shot me. It is not the Dinkas who shot me, neither the Agar. They are a group of few people which have no human values and are a shame for their community. Rumbek does not shot his bishop. Rumbek does not beat and kill priests, as it happened few years ago. Rumbek does not mistreat religious brothers or sisters. Rumbek does not abuse any person. This is what we want from Rumbek. The opposite should never happen again. And I invite the community leaders and local chiefs to spot out violent members of their community and apply the customary law, which do not tolerate violence, especially when it can be avoided. Do not allow violent members to help all the community hostage. Dinka culture have no room for violence. Violence is not part of any culture in the world. The teaching of the church is clear. It speaks of the gospel. This is the message that we have to preach with our words and also with our example of life. The gospel I read last Sunday before of the attack, it was on the Good Shepherd. And we saw the difference between a shepherd that loved the sheep and a shepherd that instead tend the sheep for his own personal interest. I am sorry to admit that this mentality of the world, that is the mentality of the devil, sometimes affects also us, people of the church. We think to bring development to ourselves and to our clans. And for this we commit all sorts of iniquity. But please, let us convert, let us change our mind. It should not be like that. And so now, from this bed of the hospital, I bend low in front of God and intercede for the Church of Rumbek. I pray for the conversion of sinners. I offer the pain I'm going through so that the Lord our God may purify the Church of Rumbek from all errors. And things like this may happen no more. No room for violence, division, selfish desires that comes from the devil. Let us work instead to form a church according to the teaching of Jesus, a church that is one, which means united, that is holy, which means gospel-like, that make people to be holy, Catholic, which means that embraces everyone, no matter the clan, the tribe, or the skin color, and apostolic, which means that comes to us from Jesus through the Pope and the bishops. And Pope Francis and the College of Bishops sent me to you, people of Rumbek, for this mission, to make the church one, holy, Catholic, and apostolic. And I will accomplish this mission with all my heart, for the love of you and the love of South Sudan. Let me be a sign for all of you, as I will rise from this bed and walk again. Let Rumbek also rise again and walk the way of peace and unity.